Let's take a look at personality disorders. What are personality disorders? Personality disorders are maladaptive patterns of behavior relating to others in three specific areas of functioning: the thoughts and emotions, interpersonal participation, and impulse management. So now when we think about a personality disorder, we think about the fact that these symptoms and these behaviors that we're seeing, they're not caused by another psychiatric disorder. Also, we begin to see this early during their adolescence or maybe during a person's early adulthood. So what is the epidemiology? Where do these come from? And what kind of comorbidities, what other kinds of diseases might we see? So if we think about the general population, 13% of the general population have a personality disorder. And we frequently will see the personality disorder co-occurring with mood disorders, with anxiety, with eating disorders, and also with substance abuse. There are some genetic and biological factors, neurobiological factors, that we might want to consider when we're thinking about personality disorders. And that is the psychological factors, environmental factors, and also stress. When you think about personality disorders, I really want you to think also about coping mechanisms, considering the fact that we see these in early adulthood and adolescence. It's often a maladaptive pattern of coping that a child has developed in order to be able to withstand an environment that is stressful, that may be abusive. And it is a way for the person to be able to continue living in that environment where, as a child, they really are powerless to change it. So personality disorders are put into three different clusters. The A cluster usually is with odd and eccentric behaviors. Your B cluster is dramatic and emotional behaviors. And your C are anxious and fearful behaviors. You might think to yourself, well, if this is happening and becoming cemented during an early childhood experience, why does a person continue to use it throughout their life? Why does it become their go-to response? I want you to think about how the brain works, about the patterns that are developed in the brain, about those neurotransmitters that help us to order the world around us. And if we find that during a moment where we're fearful for our life or for someone that we love, and being odd or eccentric, or perhaps a little dramatic or emotional, might interrupt the pattern of behavior that might be so fearful, that gets imprinted in our minds, and that becomes part of our personality. Another piece with personality disorders is to remember the difference between state and trait. And when I think about state, you can move from state to state if you want to change your environment. A state is something that happens in that particular environment, whereas a trait is something that is part of your own personality. You take it with you wherever you are going.